I don't think that if you're gonna grade or discuss or just I guess your thoughts on Gus Malzahn's tenure as Auburn's head coach, you have to look at the fact that there are no NCAA issues. The amount of player discretions off the field has been limited. You talk to players about him. Most of them are going to say that they like him, that they were treated fair. You saw what he did from a social injustice standpoint going into this season, he and Bruce Pearl getting together and trying to better the situation for a lot of the players on his roster. And then obviously you didn't have him personally have any issues off the field. He handled himself the right way. He handled himself with class and dignity. He handled himself as a professional. And I think that if you're affiliated with Auburn University or a fan of Auburn University, you have to also appreciate that part of what Gus Malzahn did and what Gus Malzahn was as the Auburn head football coach.
Alan Greene, one of the top ADs, was very highly, wanted around the country. What does this mean about here's the first one for him to see how he and the university work together to find his guy now? What do you think about that?
I think athletic directors at a lot of schools are put in very difficult situations because you might want to hire somebody. You might have an idea who to go hire. You might have a short list inside of your desk, which every AD will tell you that they have for every athletics head coaching position that they have under their umbrella. But there are also people who have a lot of influence that want someone else hired or their guy hired or their person hired. And sometimes I think that's going to be the way that things go. So it's hard to tell how much actual influence that he'll have. I think his job becomes more important after that person is put in place, that he continues to help them grow, flourish, and be the best football coach that they can be at Auburn once they're named.
And two more quick questions. That Alabama's 10-0. I mean, this is the program that you're looking at, that brother program right down the road. Is that what they're saying? I mean, we got to be the top. This isn't acceptable, 6-4.
No, I don't think you sit there and say we have to be that, because there are only maybe two other schools that are that, and that would be Clemson and Ohio State. And I don't think Ohio State has even been that in the last 10 years. Clemson would be the closest, and they have not even been that as long. So it's great to strive for that and say that you would like to be that one day, but you can't have that as your short-term reality. To me, this is about consistency, and this is about a relationship that ran stale. Gus and Auburn were cohabitating, in my opinion, and that's why the timing of this is irrelevant as far as I'm concerned. You can talk about the money, the buyout, whatever. Auburn ain't paying that buyout, so it doesn't matter. The people who think that they're sending their daughter and their tuition money is going to Gus, sitting at home with Christy and his grandkids, that's not a real thing. So I think that this now is more about finding someone who can bring more consistency, and that the people who are behind Auburn Athletics can all get in line and help pull it in the same direction. Because when Auburn has been at their best, most people are on board. I don't even think it takes all. Most need to be on board and pulling in the same direction. And if that can begin to happen, then I think Auburn can at least be competitive on an annual basis with what Alabama and Florida and A&M and then Clemson and Ohio State are doing on an every year basis.
And my last question, I mean, you obviously have a radio show and you'd put stuff out. I'm not here to ask you who do you think is going to be the guy, but how quick and how important is this search going to be in your opinion? You think it's going to be around the corner, or you think they're going to really look and maybe that coach is still coaching? I don't know. Like, what are you thinking about this process?
I don't think there's going to be you're not going to look. I don't think they need a search party. They sure as hell don't need a search firm, because that is the biggest waste of money in collegiate athletics. But I think you don't make a move like this unless you know at least fairly well who your guy is or who your guys are that you can get one of. And with the early signing period coming up, 7 days away, I think you have to think there needs to be someone in place before we get to that day. So I don't think it will be long. It's not going to be a drawn out process. I don't think you're going to be seeing candidate number one turned it down. Now they're on candidate four. Oh, they got to go to the next guy. You're not paying that kind of a buyout for someone who did have the success that Malzahn had, because he did have real success, to move on to the next person if you don't have a pretty good idea who that is.